The Wosox get ready to swing it for the first time against a young right-hander, Alek Manoah. He's a good one. He struck out 12 against Worcester on May 6th. He's not allowed a run at all this year. There's the big right-hander. Number 6 prospects in the Toronto system. He can really bring it. 11th overall pick in 2019. And the Jays, Jay, they really like him.
Yeah, they like him enough to where, despite the fact that he didn't pitch last year with the season being gone, as we take a look at the Wosox lineup, they've put him here at AAA and certainly have reaped the rewards in those two starts that he's had so far. This lineup, going to have to figure out how to solve Manoah. Wosox have been susceptible to the strikeout. That's been sort of their one Achilles heel so far, and there's a guy that can certainly deliver the strikeouts.
He looks ready, hasn't he? He's geared up. Let's see if the Wosox can put together some better ABs against this right-hander. Get to see him for a second time. Jarren Duran, those 5 homers, as you see, in 50 at-bats, leads the club, tied for third in AAA East. Manoah from the stretch. And a fastball by Duran, who got a piece of it. Manoah is 23 from Homestead, Florida. 2 games, 2 wins, 3 hits in 12 innings, 2 walks, 17 strikeouts. How about that? Number 6 prospect, according to MLB.com. Good matchup here. Power against power, and Duran could not hold up. He took something off it, it looked like. Manoah is very locked in. Just the fastball with some downward movement. Our Ooze and then Santana, all 3 of these guys homered last night. They have the shift. This is Smith. And a 6-3 out in Duran. So they were shading Duran up the middle. And Kevin Smith makes the play. Not an easy tax tonight against Alek Manoah, but
you're going to have your hands full. And this Bison's defense, Mike, an experienced team with Cologne in left field. Wall covers a lot of ground in center. Only 7 errors. They statistically best defensive team, one of the best pitching teams, one of the best hitting teams. So that's why yesterday's win for Worcester 9-4 in fine fashion really felt like a big victory to start off this 6-game series against what's going to be a tough team. And getting a guy like Araúz back certainly will help.
Yeah, that home run you see last night for the switch hitter who made his major league debut last July, and he watches all the way from Manoah. How about this run support? In his first AAA start, Buffalo wins 10-1. In his second, 12-0. But he still held his end of the bargain, showing Bunt Araúz. I mean, he gave up 2 hits against Worcester, 1 hit to Rochester. And they're not letting him go that deep. 81 pitches in his first start, 76 in his second. Now, Jay, he spent last year at the alternate site, which we have seen has been really good for a lot of players. Foul back by Araúz, 95 of the fastball. And a nice grab. And that went in the press box, I believe, where the writers are.
Get that souvenir up there. You mentioned it, first round selection, 2019. Trying to get it up to Joe McDonald in that press box. He's up there somewhere.
Yeah, I think the fans want the ball.
Manoah goes from West Virginia to Vancouver. And, Mike, then you have the season shut down.
Yeah.
You go to the alternate site. And we talked about this on the radio broadcast yesterday. Which prospects do you push? Which ones do you hold back? What do organizations kind of, how do they handle that lost minor league season? And here, a ton of confidence in Manoah. And early on, easily you can see how smooth that delivery is. It's an effortless 94, 95 miles an hour.
Maybe an overthrow there, but trying to get Araúz the chase. It certainly is. I mean, and the other thing, too, we see pitchers in this Toronto system built like this. Nate Pearson is even bigger, and we will see him. What a start to his AAA career. Good battle here. Pop up for large and foul ground near his dugout.
Yeah, and for a few years, the Blue Jays really haven't been able to develop that top-tier front of the rotation type player. And they feel like they've got this next wave with Manoah and Pearson, so much so that those are two guys. Pearson's already been up. I think there's a lot of fans clamoring and looking at this start specifically for Manoah to say, hey, is he ready to contribute to a team that's really, you know, pushing the Red Sox right now at the top of the East?
Inside and low. They thought Aaron Sanchez was going to be that
Sanchez,
next big thing.
Stroman was a guy.
Stroman, yes. But in their wave of position players that they graduated to the big leagues.
Going back to the old Kyle Drabek. Well, they've had some guys that, you know, really haven't developed to that frontline starter.
Good at bat, ball four. He really worked the count. Manoah very upset as he just turned his back. Jay and I, we are broadcasting live from the IBEW Local 96 broadcast booth, proud sponsor of the Worcester Red Sox.
Hey, you're talking about a guy that hasn't allowed a run, Mike. Do you put a hit and run on here with Danny Santana, or do you try a straight steal with Araúz, who does have the speed? I mean, it feels like every foot is going to matter against a guy like Manoah, who hasn't given up any ground this season.
Yeah, interesting question with a big leaguer who was technically on a rehab. It's called a minor league rehab because he's not officially on Boston's 40-man because he got hurt. But I would think, yeah, he might want to develop in things that he's not done at the plate, to hit and run for his sake. And he hits a fly ball to deep right field. Warmoth, though, there. And there's two outs. Sounded like he cracked the bat. But that ball did not go as far as I thought.
I was just going to mention that because everything we've seen that has had that type of trajectory, velocity off the bat, has either been a wall ball or gone. And this one, for whatever reason, I think it's Manoah getting it in on Santana enough to snap the bat, as you mentioned, or at least crack it. He went down to golf that one out of here and just kind of stagnant in right field for Santana. It's just going to be hard to clobber him against Manoah.
That was a great shot. You could see as he hit it, he was dejected. Araúz scampers back. Here's Bruce Crabb, who does a great job working with the infielders. I think the big thing, too, when you come to the ballpark, if you're just watching, tuning into a game, and you've not been to a ballpark, when you come in, look at the flags. If they're blowing out to right field, the ball will fly.
Yeah.
And they're not moving.
We've seen it fly even without
the
win, but that certainly has been part of the story here in the first eight games of Polar Park history.
Jairo Munoz says the first hit in Woo Sox history was fooled as he swatted at that pitch. That was a off-speed pitch up and in from Alek Manoah. It's not Alex, it's Alek. I tried typing that today and it kept correcting me. Look at this. He was fooled.
Yep.
I wanted to hold back, couldn't. But I agree with you on doing some type of running here because you might not get many chances with a guy on base. That's how good Manoah is. Pretty quick to the plate and a breaking ball fouled back. So they've gone with breaking balls here.
And you could see Munoz on that first one, a little fooled here, just tries to fight it off. And now you've set him up nicely for that 94-mile-an-hour fastball. He's been able to kind of get a little sink to it, almost like a two-seamer that has run on Woo Sox hitters.
Yeah, that's when this is a spot where you're throwing right down the middle. He's probably not thinking, right? Fastball, 0-2. Oof, just missed.
It. Yeah.
A little backwards pitching. And that really wasn't down the middle, but that was pretty darn close. Just off the edge. That's a really good pitch.
Threw it where he wanted it.
And Munoz didn't chase. Didn't again. Another slider. Araúz, the runner at first base. Now, he's a good runner. You see the numbers on the back of Buffalo. That looks like the font of the Blue Jays. wearing the red. And nowadays in the minor leagues, minor league teams have so many different uniforms and hats. Then there's no way that's about selling merchandise, right?
Absolutely
that's
all,
it's
not,
about style.
You know, these guys have to wear the Trenton Thunder jerseys when they're playing their home games in New Jersey because they've been displaced from Buffalo. So that adds another set of unis into the mix.
Let's see if Ara Ooze runs here. Nope. Swing and a miss. Got him with that off-speed pitch. Munoz saw a lot of them in that first at bat. So the one-out walk is left, and we're scoreless after one at Polar Park. Wow, look at this place. It is beautiful. Cathedral here, Polar Park. And the Woo Sox have won five in a row. They're 6-1, Jay, in this palace.
Yeah, it's really added to the opening homestand magic. Started with James Taylor singing the national anthem, Pedro Martinez, all the dignitaries here. And then you go on to actually win games and do so at an exciting level in a high fashion with guys like this, Marcus Wilson, electric players. Wilson had the first home run in park history, a shot over the right field wall. He's been a standout player. Jeter Downs coming back after a slow start. He's starting to pick things up. So we'll see if this Woo Sox lineup can get anything against Manoah, who's now been staked to a 2-0 lead.
And you're right. On your first homestand ever, you want to win some games, and they sure did. Ooh, some elbow music. Wilson hitting fifth has hit safely in four straight. I just like the whole demeanor. We'll get a shot at this. This is 95 right at your elbow, your chest. Marcus getting a night off from the field, but they want his bat in there. He's hit safely in four straight. There's good old-fashioned pitching. He went in and then threw him a slider away. Like the flags. I like that how the Bisons have that, the USA and the Canadian flag on the right sleeve there, representing the Blue Jays. Another slider. That's nasty. That thing took off. That's unhittable. Good slider hitters, don't swing at them. There's Casey Candel, who played for Buffalo, the skipper. Downs and then Chris Herman. Juan Graterol with a two-run home run in the top of the inning, and fastball 95, no chance. Man, Manoah's good.
Yeah, and you said it there in that first pitch where then he went back to the slider. He's also just an intimidating presence out there on the mound.
He's
the beard,
fired
he's all
up.
Tatted up. And you started with the fastball in, almost hit Wilson, slider, and then you come back with a fastball, and not really a chance there for Marcus Wilson to compete in that at-bat against Manoah.
Yeah, this is an event for Manoah. A lot of animation. Here is Jeter Downs, number two prospect in the Red Sox system, and that slider again spins in. Downs at 244 in 12 games. A home run on this homestand, five RBIs. Jeter's brother Jerry is in the Red Sox system, so Jerry, he was psyched when that trade happened. No chance there with that fastball.
Yeah, it just feels like the plan for the Woo Sox when they step into the box is just dismantled by what Manoah does on the first pitch. And now you're flailing at a fastball, 95, not sure kind of where it's going to be. He is in command right now.
And this is where, even though they faced Manoah before, when you execute with this stuff, it really doesn't matter. Another slider, another swing and miss, and he's fanned three in a row. Now, we talk about this. We talked a little off the air about this, the more you face somebody. But when you face a guy like this, if you face Max Scherzer three or four times within a couple months, if he executes, Jay, the pitcher can still win.
Yeah, stuff is stuff. No matter how many times you see him, you just can't get around on it, can't hit, you know, other guys that don't have the repertoire of Manoah. You can tinker a little bit. Maybe you throw a pitch that they haven't seen as much or haven't seen from you. And here he's just purely setting guys up with that slider, using the fastball.
Chris Herman gives it a try. Chris has been catching a lot with Connor Wong still day-to-day with a hamstring injury. Herman, the first homer in team history. The 2019 draft is where Manoah was taken 11th overall, and already we know players from that draft a couple of years ago. Bobby Witt Jr., Andrew Vaughn of the White Sox. Manoah was the 11th pick overall. Foul ball hit hard down the right field line. And the Major League Baseball draft has changed, where it used to be over the phone and now MLB Network carries it. And Jay, it's not taking these guys very long to get to the big leagues.
Well, no, and it's also truncated in terms of the rounds. They sort of chop that down year by year. But
yeah,
guys are working on their craft year-round. So they're not just using the minor league season and that span to develop. This is a pursuit that they're sedulous in trying to obtain.
Here's a drive by Herman to center. Does it have the legs? It does! Into the green for a home run with two outs. So both catchers have homered in this game. And Chris Herman with his second of the year to dead center. Manoah provided the power and a big smile for Herman. That's a long home run.
Hey, Mike, you can score off of Manoah. How about another dinger for the Woo Sox? Manoah with the fastball, Herman right on it. As you said, his second home run, the 17th home run, and seven-plus games now onto the eighth game for the Woo Sox at this park.
Geddes takes strike one.
Say, hey, maybe you're not invincible out there on the mound in the third start of the season for Manoah. Finally get a run.
Outside, that ball was hammered. It took off. Manoah looks shocked. That's the first run, as you mentioned, that he's allowed in 13 and two-thirds in AAA. And it comes on a home run, of course. Geddes hit his first home run Tuesday night here, late on a fastball. Second home run for Chris Herman, both against Buffalo. Of course, he hit the first in team history. And Buffalo was the home team, but it was not in Buffalo. It was in Trenton, New Jersey. There's that slider, and finally someone put it in play, or got a piece of it. So both teams, the lower part of the order, responsible for the scoring. Geddes at 179, a home run, four RBIs, only his 40th at bat. Hitting eighth for Billy McMillan. Got the fastball by him. So three strikeouts in the inning for Manoah, similar to Gonzalez's second. But the home run by Herman, bullseye, dead center. The Woo Sox on the board. Children of all ages, yes, you, 15 and younger, are welcome to sign up for the Woo Sox Woo Crew presented by Shaw's. The Woo Crew is the team's kids club, and it's free to sign up. Become a rookie club member, and you receive a number of really cool benefits. Sign up by going to WooSox.com or downloading the Woo Crew app on your mobile device. So that youngster there, she's getting ready to do that. She probably has a phone. I like the pink hat.
Oh. The Woo Sox merchandise, I got to say.
Oh, Jay's down there every
day. It is so fire, as the kids say. You got polos and
lit, right? Those are the cool words?
No.
Ball one from Manoah. Akemi is the only starter in this game that is not hit. Rounds out the nine. Akemi, five straight. He's hit safely, and he's up to 182 with two homers and five RBIs. And a good matchup here, and a line drive foul. Man, he blasted that down the right field line. Power against power. I love these matchups. See the fair pole. Go figure, they always called it a foul pole. If you hit it, it's fair. But there's means if you hit to the right of it, it's foul. But I like the half full. We label it fair. strike. Another slider. He's thrown a lot of those. Duran and then Araúz against Manoah. Now his lone blemish is the home run by Herman with two outs in the second. He has fanned four. There's Akemi, the wide stance. That hangs outside.
Yeah, just curious here for Akemi. As we've talked about in his career, he can get back in counts. Goes behind one and two, now takes a ball outside. Can he foul off the stuff from Manoah? Or is Manoah just too overpowering?
There's another breaking ball lifted on the left side. He really launched this one. Large would need a ticket and would probably not get one from these fans.
See Akemi here in his last game before he left prematurely in that contest. Two walks and a hit by pitch. I mean, this is a guy, it says, can he foul it off? He does in the short term.
They're saying no. Oh, look at that.
Oh, one hop. Hey, honey, I got you something.
And Akemi strikes out 94 right by him. So the last five outs have been strikeouts. So the last six batters, five Ks and a home run. A part of this game is stuff, but you can tell from the broadcast booth, when you're at a game live, and I know a lot of fans, you can feel confidence, and Manoah has it. Swagger, that's what the cool kids say, right?
A little swagger. This guy's got some in his own right. Duran
certainly does. Five homers. Grounded to short his first time, ball one. And Large has to play in at third because Duran is still very fast. So the power and the speed. Kind of a left-handed version of Ricky Henderson. Ricky was way beyond his years, wasn't he? Going to show Duran yesterday. He loves this ballpark, Jaron Duran.
Yeah, we've seen Duran go to right field. This one out to right center field yesterday, a two-run blast. And
right in that window. Yeah,
no doubt about it. Five dingers on the year for Duran, four on this homestand.
Not many leadoff hitters can do what he can do. Took a lot off that. That looked like a changeup. So much movement in. We've seen a lot of pitches to Duran in and down. That makes sense.
Yeah, we haven't seen as much stuff up against Duran after he hit that 95-mile-an-hour fastball out to right field against Syracuse. They started pitching him down and away and down and in.
And he lays off a good pitch.
That's a good take there from Duran.
Yep. Manoah, he's constantly staring in. He's not mad at the umpire, but he's
sizing
just so
you up.
Locked in. Yeah. On that circle, that batter's circle. How's he pitch with that big chain, though? Guys do it.
Yep.
2-2. Duran stays alive.
Yeah, it's like he's got blinders on. And he's just solely focused, right? See, he's off the mound, but he's rubbing up the baseball, staring into your soul, telepathically telling you how he's going to strike you out.
Five home runs? Yeah, whatever. He's a big dude. 6'6", 260, only 23. And maybe he's pitching in the big leagues this year. Oh, good slider. That one right in on his hands. Can't blame Duran. Strikeout number seven. That is nasty. He's thrown a lot of different varieties of that slider. That one coming right in on Duran. Look at the swing. I mean, what is he supposed to do? He's trying to just stop it.
Yeah, try to hold it back. We've seen him start off a few at-bats with just a kind of a regular curveball to get it over for a strike. Then he's got more of the sweeping hard slider and kind of the little cutter with slider action. This is a guy, and this tells you how much guys can get better and develop, went undrafted out of high school.
Crazy.
And so when someone tells you, hey, you're not big enough, hey, you don't throw hard enough, or whatever it might be, you can develop into a Major League Baseball player.
Part of the development, you're saying, right? Hey, I didn't get drafted. I got a chip on my shoulder.
Well, that 9 times out of 10 for those guys, for sure.
Well, Duran, I think, has that. Seventh-round pick. Bounce to second. Herrera will throw out Araúz in a perfect inning for Alek Manoah, who has fanned 7 through 3 innings. It's still a gorgeous night for baseball as the Bisons lead 2-1 at Polar Park.
Well, the U Sox keep it a 2-1 deficit on a heads-up defensive play from Jeter Downs and company. Hilton Garden Inn, if you're traveling to a U Sox game, is the official hotel of the Worcester Red Sox. And a big thanks to Chloe for joining us here in the booth and singing the national anthem today. Man, she's got a lot of energy.
Yeah.
And you know she's going to have success in her career.
Just the... Not very old, right?
Yeah, 17.
And
what were you doing at 17 years of age?
I wasn't talking about hanging out with Lionel Richie and Katy Perry. Very confident, but what a nice person, too, and we wish her the best. And maybe someday we'll say, remember, we had that.
She was up here with us, yeah. So now the U Sox will try to even things up against Manoah, who has thrown 47 pitches or 48 pitches through 3 innings. Santana will lead things off, followed by Munoz and Marcus Wilson. And if we get a chance to show you that play that ended the top half of this inning, it really helped out Gonzalez, who had walked a pair and was laboring to throw strikes. Santana with a fly out and his first at bat, and he pushes one down the left field line. Colon can't get it, and it's off the wall. Another extra base hit for the big leaguer Santana. And he is really pressing the issue here for the Boston Red Sox. Don't be surprised if he's not with Worcester come next week.
Yeah, he's played left field now twice, but I love his swings the other way. It looks like he's trying to serve this ball to left field. Look at that swing.
Looked like the home run swing he had yesterday. Pushed out to left field.
No, Jay Colon had a good read on this. It just took off on him.
So Santana gets it by him, and now Munoz, who looked a little perplexed back in the first inning in his pursuit of a Manoah fastball, is in there. And Manoah misses low for 94 miles an hour for ball one, and we're seeing just the first few chinks in the armor of Manoah this season.
You really want to cash in here on a lead double.
1-0. Good pitch.
I know it might sound dramatic, Jay, but when you're facing a guy like this, a leadoff double, you must get him in.
Yeah, without a doubt. And you do have some speed with Santana at second. Munoz, just one extra base hit as a member of the Woo Sox. Big league time, past couple of the seasons with St. Louis. 1-1. Hard grounder snagged by Large. Nice play as he flags it, throws the first, and just gets Munoz. And unable, unfortunately, for Munoz, despite the fact he hit it well, he cannot advance the base runner in Santana from second.
That's an inning changer. That was a great play. And Large stayed so focused on a ball that was torched on one hop. I mean, this almost took his glove off. Stayed with it, stumbled a bit. Buffalo is tied for fifth in defense. In AAA East, .985 fielder percentage. And you love it when you have that defense at the corners.
Yeah, that was a superb play from Large. Unable to advance the runner. Now Wilson also looked a little bit lost in his first at-bat, stands in. Wu Sox down by a run, 2-1.
Got away one on Wilson.
Yeah, absolutely. A little hanger from Manoah. But when you have the repertoire that he has, you can get away with that every once in a while.
You could see Wilson saying, oh, this guy's been dotting I's, crossing T's all game, and I got a hanger. But you're right. Wilson, the intimidation factor, you can get away with one.
Wilson knows he's not going to get another one like that. Struck out in his last at-bat, did Marcus Wilson. And he chops it on the ground to third. Foul. It has been a remarkable homestand, opening up Polar Park with 12 games in 13 days. And the Woo Sox winning 6 out of the first 7. They've won 5 straight. They've packed the park to max capacity each and every night. Knock on wood, there's been no rain. And just a few hiccups along the way, health-wise, for the Woo Sox. Losing Connor Wong in the opener. Bizardo yesterday pitched to just one batter before he left with injury. Wilson has been locked in for Worcester.
Wow. That's a pretty good pitch on 0-2.
I think Wilson's saying, what am I going to do with that if I took a swing at it? Just missing there from Manoah as we take a look at the Manny's Appliance replay. The official appliance realtor of the Worcester Red Sox. Just 56 pitches for the righty Manoah. Swing and a miss.
Elevated slider. And that thing really, it different shapes and sizes from that slider. Watch this thing take off. It changes the eye level of the hitters nicely. Throwing a slider up, down, I mean. Jay, if you have that in your back pocket with 95, 96, that's a tough cookie.
That's 7 strikeouts for Manoah. And as you mentioned, Mike, you got to figure out how to bring in Santana. It'll be up to Jeter Downs. 3 of 8 on the young season with runners in scoring position. Downs made the nice play defensively to double off the runner to end the top half of this inning. And what felt like a bit of a base running blunder for the trail runner, Riley Adams. And a nice catch by Geddes in right field.
Yeah, Adams just assumed Geddes wasn't going to catch it, I guess. He just took off from first. Boy, Santana's been doing a lot of talking to Herrera, saying, just stay put.
Off speed again from Manoah for strike 2. And the Woo Sox coming and falling behind in counts here against Manoah.
This is a front door slider. Look where this is. We'll see if he pitches backwards. We've seen this a lot. Fastballs on 0-2 counts.
Got him. 8 Ks for the prospect Manoah, and the Woo Sox leave the double at second and Santana. We're through 4. It's a 2-1 game from Polar Park. Buffalo gets a run on a little bleeder base hit. Might take a 3-1 lead. Woo Sox will host Friday fireworks at Polar Park after every Friday night home game. The shows will be set to various musical themes, from the music of Worcester to Motown and more, presented by Unibank. Catch the fireworks after every Friday night home game, as well as July 3rd and 4th here at Polar Park. We had our first Friday night fireworks last week. We got the next one coming up this weekend.
Can't wait.
Mike Antonellis loves fireworks. 20 years in minor league baseball, still not deterred from seeing so many fireworks. The fans here are going to love them. And here's the first pitch to Herman, who's homered today, as the Woo Sox try to bump up the pitch count of Manoah, who has looked very sharp once again.
Yeah, 42 of 60 pitches for strikes. That's not normal.
Bottom of the order for Worcester. And you would imagine Gonsalves, his day is done after 93 pitches. But Manoah is still going strong. He threw 76 pitches in his last outing Wednesday in a win against Scranton. 2-0. Out the third, Large sizing it up. And straddling the line, he makes the catch. One gone in the fifth. And just not a lot going against Manoah, but more this time for the Woo Sox than last time, where he struck out 12 and kept you off the scoreboard. There's Schreiber, John Schreiber warming up, part of this real extensive bullpen. You've got more arms available to you now than you've had in the past with the rule changes and roster expansion and taxi squads. And no matter the combination of pitchers out of that pen this series, they've all been good.
They have.
Saw Brandon Workman again yesterday. Geddes trying to get Manoah out of his rhythm. Strike one on Geddes. He's 0 for 1 today with a strikeout. Geddes, 31 dingers in 2019 with El Paso, off to a slow start with Worcester up until the past 2 days. Geddes getting on base throughout the game. Base hit, walked, brought home a run, and then hit the dinger. Out to left field, his first as a member of Worcester. This was his sliding catch yesterday as well, motoring in. He also made a catch today out in right field, leading to a double play ball. Not a bad day.
That sliding catch, though, I mean, he corralled that down near his left hip. Great concentration from the veteran.
Yeah, new organization, trying to get acclimated, and now finally getting into a groove. Tough pitch on that sweeping slider from Manoah.
That might be his best pitch tonight. Yeah. Throws hard, but this slider is nasty.
Took a bid very close on Geddes. That's a tough pitch to take. But that evens it up against Manoah. Manoah walked a man back in the first inning. Gave up a home run in the second. And a double last inning. Nubbed foul by Geddes. That's what you have to do at this point. Foul off some pitches. See if you can get deeper into the pitch count for Manoah. You know the Blue Jays don't want to kind of extrapolate 100 pitches out of him today. They're more in the 70, 75 range. And rampant wild internet speculation, which is what we all love and go off of, suggests that Manoah, with the start today, as things have gone according to plan, could get up to the big leagues, and rightfully so, as he blows away Geddes for out number two.
Yeah, Ross Stripling, who is pitching for the Blue Jays now, has allowed 6 runs to the Red Sox. So he would be potentially.
And Manoah was supposed to start yesterday. They bumped him back to today. So if you kept things in line, you could potentially displace a pitcher like Stripling, who's struggling right now with the debut of Manoah. But you'd have to make some roster moves as well. And here's Josh Ockamy. Struck out back in the third inning. 9 Ks for Manoah. You know, the Blue Jays have had all sorts of injuries, and they've still been able to go pound for pound with the Red Sox. That East is really wide open, despite the fact that Boston has, you know, led for the majority of the season.
Yeah, I like that it's competitive. People don't want to see it just be two clubs, as Ockamy did swing here. Here, the fans didn't think so, but he did. Toronto, I mean, the way they have drafted and developed players.
Shot high in the air, not all that deep. Wall staring into the Worcester sky, and he's there to make the catch. Stammered a bit, but he's got it in a 1-2-3. For Manoah. Woo Sox get none. Manoah cruising through 5. 3-1 Bisons. What's the Red Sox Booster Club presented by Window World. If you're not a member, you can sign up for free at WooSox.com to earn exclusive member benefits, cool access, be a part of this foundation and franchise as it grows throughout central Massachusetts and extending all throughout New England, from the Berkshires to the Bay, all the way up to Maine and beyond. Our Red Sox Nation is boundless.
Yeah, they're in every state, yeah. Which you know when you watch a Red Sox game on the road. Boston South, they would say, in Tampa Bay.
Here's Jaron Duran to lead off. WooSox hoping that this will be the last inning for Manoah. He has thrown 72 pitches up to this point. Duran 0 for 2 today. Takes the first one, a slider for ball one.
That's a good part of the order. Top three, Duran, Araúz, and Santana.
Got to say, WooSox defensively have been a little bit unlucky. Little bleeding base hit, scored a run. Bloop double, swinging a foul back for strike one on Duran. And the heart-shaped lights and the Worcester sky playing tricks on the outfielders in that last inning. Mirage, if you would. And now as those light stanchions get into the evening, you can see if you go down a little bit, we've got the different colors illuminating from the base of the lights. Line to short, and a leaping grab for Smith.
Yeah, perfect timing by Smith on that soft line drive. It was not hit hard. Smith saying, I knew it. I knew when to jump. And last night, Jay, on those light stanchions, it was red, and we got the blue tonight. Look at him just wait. Yep. That's perfect timing.
A nice play by Smith. So 0 for 3 today for Duran. Araúz with a walk. Nasty pitch taken low for ball one. Araúz with a tape measure home run yesterday in the fourth inning. There's the LED lighting. Yeah, yesterday that was a red tone, and I've got the blue tonight. Just adds a little of that ambiance to this ballpark.
Certainly does. Even the LED lights up in the suites here, blue.
Yeah, blue is the color today. Yesterday it was red.
It's beautiful.
Club Polar Park.
Get them flashing. Boy, Jay, just looking at the numbers, Manoah has worked 17 and a third innings in AAA. He's given up 5 hits.
This is Araúz yesterday, back from Boston. Obviously not the movement he wants to have on the roster, but he'll take advantage with a dinger to right. And there he dribbles one foul. I always wonder about how a guy's going to respond. Go up and down, and oh, there's a souvenir.
Brandon Workman, 0 for 1.
Came back.
There's a net there, Brandon. I think you got to go around the net.
Wasn't always a net, right? When he was coming up?
No.
Defensive swing from Araúz, shot into the Buffalo dugout. Yeah, those extended nettings really an attribute that most of the ballparks chose to add a few years ago, and then I think kind of mandated.
I'm just thankful. Yeah. I've seen so many balls go in the stands, and now with TrackMan, we know how fast they go. I saw Michael Chavis hit a foul ball in the stands before at like 105.
Yeah.
And it's...
How are you going to react to that when you're eating
kids,
ice cream?
Yeah. And
got him, swinging a miss. That's 10. He pulled the string on Araúz.
Came all the way back, too, down 3-0. Yeah.
It looked like Araúz was on his way to first base, brought back on the 3-0 on a called strike right there, and then There's the K pitch. A wiffle ball slider.
He's like a professional wrestler. Look at this. After strikeouts, he's yelling at John Manoah. Look at, he's still going at it.
Hey,
he could cut a good promo.
Yeah.
He gets really into it. I mean, you like to see that.
Let me tell you something, Mean Gene. Here's Santana, who's doubled today. Big swing and a miss for strike one.
No better era of wrestling
without
than the
a
80s.
Doubt.
I mean, oh.
Santana, one of the two hits for the Wu Sox tonight. And that was a double over the left fielder Colon's head. Saying, all right, let's go get back in the box here. You wonder if this will be the last inning for Manoah. There is action in the bullpen. He's over 80 pitches. High heat.
Well, Santana is jawing at Manoah.
Yeah.
Yeah. These two are going at it a bit. I think Santana is mad that Manoah is maybe speaking up, and Santana saying, hey, not here.
Well, we talked about it earlier. Manoah with the blinders on, he has really been kind of staring at the opposition. See?
Yeah, Santana
barely takes his eyes off the hitter.
Stop talking and pitch, buddy.
Shake twice now, Manoah with the two-strike pitch. Just get the feeling he wanted to strike him out on the fastball.
Yes, yes, I think Santana's gotten in his head a little bit.
There it is. Hey. And another thing. How was that wrestling promo you were talking about? How badly does Santana want to win this exchange? Oh. That was the slider from Manoah. That's been the strikeout pitch. Santana explaining his plight to catcher Gratterall. Saying, what's he talking about? He's struck out 10 batters today. You like that edge for a guy like
yeah.
Both of these guys, actually.
It's our main event here tonight, Santana against Manoah.
For the main card in the 2-2. Flared into short left field, and that's going to drop in. Advantage Santana. He thought about going to second. And he'll take the win from the top rope on Manoah. Santana. Two of the three hits tonight for Worcester.
Yeah, broken bat. He tried to get in on him, but Santana is too good. And he's got two more hits. He has 13 J in his minor league rehab between Greenville, which is high A now, and Worcester.
Yeah, 13 of 29. Three home runs between the two levels. And now you're putting the Blue Jays system in an interesting situation here. Manoah's approaching 90 pitches. You probably give him one more batter in Munoz. If the Wu Sox can get Munoz aboard, that could theoretically end the day for Manoah and get you into the bullpen, which has been the goal all along.
Yeah, you want this guy certainly out. All the runs with two outs. Chris Herman's home run was with two outs in the second.
The problem is Munoz has not looked great in his two plate appearances against the right-hander Manoah today. Strike out and a ground out. That was a fun at-bat for Danny Santana taking on Manoah.
And I think it's great for the game to see that.
A little attitude, guys.
Personality, right?
Yeah, attacking each other. And clearly the game plan and the card says throw Munoz the breaking stuff.
We've seen that all homestand.
There's the action in the bullpen. Curtis Taylor throwing for Buffalo. Lined into left field. down for a base hit. Santana to second. And Munoz recognizing, hey, they're only giving me the breaking stuff. Let me wait on it.
Colon was really deep in left and already a deep left field. And you said it, Jay. Munoz was right on that, went down and got that slider. But look how far Colon is.
Well, one more batter here for Manoah as he tries to get through six innings. Tying run coming to the plate. And Marcus Wilson, who can erase a fine performance from Manoah tonight with one swing of the bat. Two runners on, two gone. Strike.
Still bringing it, 95 on the fastball.
Wilson a strikeout in the second, another in the fourth inning. Season high 91 pitches thrown in this one for Manoah. Down 0-2 is Wilson. That was a tough pitch, came in on the hands.
And this is where you have to be protecting away because he's had that slider all night. Wilson just a bit late. But you're right, Jay. This has to be his last hitter, regardless of what happens.
But he's got two strikes on Wilson. His uprising began with a base hit from Danny Santana. And then Munoz on the second pitch of his at-bat with a base hit to left field. Two-strike pitch on Wilson. Ooh.
You made a good point earlier. Puts it where he wants it. He threw a fastball earlier in the game. Same spot. I mean, look at that.
Yeah.
That's trying to get Wilson to chase. He knows it's off the plate.
Yeah, Gratterall barely had to move his mitt. And now do you go to the slider here on Wilson? We saw him elevate the slider. Line in the left field, sinking. Colon coming on, and he makes the grab. And the Woo Sox will have this one sink in sight of Port. No runs, a couple of hits, and two left on. We're through six. The Bisons still up by 3, 4-1 from Poland Park.